Hi, I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. You know, we're kind of crazy about the Apple products, the iPad, the iPod, and those kind of devices. We're going to spend a few minutes here with Carol Gert, one of our equipment specialists, talking about some really neat stuff to assist folks who have visual impairments using those Apple devices. So let's go check out what Carol has going on.
Hello, my name is Carol Gert, and I'm the equipment loan specialist at Indata. One of the things we do is lend various pieces of equipment to see if it will work for you. One of the most popular items at the moment is the iPad and the iPad 2. It has very many uses. It has uses for the hearing population, or I should say non-hearing population, and for the low vision population, as well as for communication for people who have difficulty speaking. Today I'm going to show you some apps that are really cool for the low vision populations. Now you can see on here I have a lot of applications on here. They are for various people. Let me see. This one I like really well. It's called Magnifier. It is free, and you can see my niece. Pull it out enough, you can see her. You can see all kinds of things. You can read the newspaper with it. You can see various things, and it goes from 1x all the way up to 9x. And it will take a picture and allow you to bring it up to your eyes and see it a lot easier. It could be useful in the grocery store as well. Another one is a fun one.
Nine minus three equals six.
So it's a talking calculator. And the thing that's really nice about this, too, is that it does have very large numbers. MapQuest. Okay. It's going to try to find me, but I can, with my voice, tell it where I want to go, which is always a good thing to have happen. It actually has me on Keystone Avenue and Kingsway Drive. Let's see, I can blow it up a little bit. So if I wanted to, I could go down to some of these other places and put my places and actually make it give me directions verbally. The Money Reader. This is a cool one. It's going to use the camera. And I'm going to slip this back here behind.
And $50.
There you go. And it told me how much it actually was. And it doesn't have to see the numbers to actually tell you what the bill is. It somehow reads things along the bill and tells you what it is. Another one that I found very neat, cool, is my quick recordings. I can make a note to myself. I can tell it that today I'm going to do this tech tip, and then I can play it back. I can tell it that today I'm going to do this tech tip. Now there's another one in here, and they're hard to find upside down. But this is a calendar and will give you reminders. I can say I've got to see the man about a new car, and I can stop it and it will give me a time. It's approximately 1:35 right now, and it say, okay, I'm going to give you this reminder in 5 minutes. And in 5 minutes it will speak up and remind me of my own message. So it's pretty cool. That's just a few of the applications that are on iTunes. I continually am looking for new ones every day. So thank you, and bye.
So that's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project in Indiana.